गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. आई एम ऑन माई वे फॉर एन इंटरव्यू एंड आई थॉट आई विल फिल्म द थिंग्स दैट यू नो आई एम गोइंग थ्रू. मोस्टली यू नो आई विल बी कैचिंग ए बस फ्रॉम हियर बिकॉज इट्स अराउंड 2.5 किलोमीटर्स. आई डोंट हैव अ बस पास येट सो बट आई Luckily, I do have the exact change. Like I mentioned in one of the videos before, here in buses, you have to give the exact change at the bus. You know, the bus driver, I mean, there will be a box kept at the bus driver wherein you have to drop the coins or the note or the currency. You can't, you know, they won't keep change with them. So. You can't expect them to give back the change, so you should have the exact change. So yeah, I'll be catching a bus from here, and luckily I have the exact change. So for a day, if you are you know going just for one bus, I mean irrespective of the distance you're covering in that bus, you have to give $2, right? Even if it is one stop or five stop, you have to give $2. Or the other option is a bus pass, which will cost you $4. So if you have different plans for the day, then a bus pass will be a better option. So for me, today I'll be taking a bus pass because it's early morning and I might go to, you know, place I'm going to is Aberdeen, and from there I will have to go to a few other places, mainly to pick up a courier from the post office, which is at a different location. So I'll have to catch multiple buses. So I'll probably take a one day pass, which will cost me $4. Yep. I'll try to film inside the bus as well, so that you guys get to know how it is. Yep. Okay, so I just reached the bus stop. The one that you can see here is the one. So this is at Magilat Summit. So there are two bus stops actually on both opposite sides. So you have to be sure on the way that you are going. So in the map, you can basically check the route that you have to go. I mean, in my case, I have to go through to TRU. So TRU is on this side. So I should be standing at this bus stop. There is another one on the other side, so you have to be careful about that. So other than that, this is the morning view. Since it is early morning, there is hardly anyone here, but looks really good. And this is the Real Canadian Store, and then you got Wendy's here, and you got Starbucks and Domino's on that side. Hope you can see that. And then next to the petrol gas station that you can see, that is Freshco. So you know, in this area you got mostly everything. So the bus is coming, and hello, good morning.
Two bus was please.
Two days. Thank you. Yeah, good day. I'm inside the bus, and in the bus you got this display there, which will tell you the next stop. And so, once it is your stop, you can press the bell that you are seeing here. Getting inside the bus is through the front door, and you know, exit is through the you know, back door. And you know, to be polite, it's a good thing to, you know, just say thanks to the driver when you're stepping out. Just wave at them, and they'll be looking through the rear mirror. Going through the TRU campus now. stop button, you can also pull the yellow line that you are seeing, right? So that will also will inform the driver that you have to, you know, someone will have to get down at the next stop. I'm just waiting to go back now, catch the second bus. So this is the best bus. So best is here. Hello, morning. So morning I took a day pass. The day pass usually cost $4. The reason I took a bus pass today was because morning I had to go for an interview, and then now I'm going to the Canada Post to collect a winter jacket that I ordered. So I'll talk about it in a bit. I did show the day pass in the morning, just to show you again. So this is the one. It looks like this. So it is valid for a day. It has some terms and conditions. Like your day pass is valid for the date shown on the ticket, pass is not transferable, etc., etc. Right? So this is the thing. So it costs you $4. And yeah, coming on to Canada Post, I did order a winter jacket and a boot, because the one that I'm wearing now, it's not a winter jacket as such. I did use this in UK and Paris, and it was pretty okay there, but for the you know, climate here, I mean, it's not you know, good. I mean, you can really feel the breeze and the cold. So this we can't use. Maybe if the temperature is you know, on the positive side, then maybe you can use, but when it goes to the negative below zero, then this is not of use. So I did order a winter jacket and the boot, so that I can easily walk on the snow. It was supposed to be delivered on 31st of December, and when I checked the post box in the apartment, I could see only a slip inside the box, and the slip was from the Canada Post, and it had their address and the date and time when I can go there and pick the items. I think the reason for they left the slip there is because the items might be large and the box here is pretty small, so that might not fit in. That could be the reason. But otherwise, I'm not sure. I'm pretty sure that they do deliver. I mean, if you order an item from Amazon, they do deliver things at your doorstep, and for everything you don't have to go to Canada Post. But in this case, I am. I'm carrying the slip that they kept there, and also two ID proofs. One is my passport, and then the study permit that I got, just in case if they ask for anything. So I'm just carrying that. Once I have my driving license, I will no more be carrying the passport around with me, or the BCID card, right? Okay, so I'll continue once I'm there at the Canada Post. I just reached the place. The Canada Post is inside London Drugs. London Drugs is a store which has all the electronic equipments and many other things. I even bought my SIM card from London Drugs. Yeah, so I'm just going there. I'm inside the London Drugs store. So as you can see, it's a normal store. I don't know why the name London Drugs. Not sure if it has any reasons for it, but as you can see, the Canada Post is right there, so we'll be going there. I just googled why the name London Drug, and it seems it's named after London, England, the home of Canada's King George VI. After World War II, London struck carried the promise of peace and prosperity. And now London Drugs seems to have stores in 35 major markets throughout BC and many other provinces. Right. So that's FII. So as I mentioned, I got my SIM card, the local SIM card here in Canada, from the London Drug Store. One of my friends here told me that London Drugs will be able to advise on the best plan that's running, and that's the reason I came here. I took that a week back. So when you are here in London Drug, you have to come to the cashier. As you can, there is a big board named cashier, so you can go there and get it. There is a computer section, there is a photo imaging center, and also, as you have seen, the Canada Post is inside the London Drugs. The cashier will be able to help you with the different SIM cards and plans that's available. So for me, I took the public service, which has a tie-up with TELUS. So far it's good, I mean the data is working well. I'm done at the post office, I mean Canada Post, and I got the box. It's a bit, I mean they have packed it in a big box, and that could be the reason, like I said, they didn't keep it inside the box there in my apartment. So yeah, at the Canada Post I had to show my passport and an address proof. Luckily I had a bank statement with me, which had my name and the address of the place where I'm staying, so that was good enough for them. So just if you are going to Canada Post to get a parcel order for you, then make sure that you're carrying these documents. Right, I hope the video is useful. Please do like and subscribe. Take care, bye.